Welcome back to the fourth video in this series about copying and merging topologies in ice. So far, you've learned how to generate a building with a slider to control the number of floors. However, you still need to transfer the polygon material IDs from the templates properly. You need to replace the merged material ID compound with your own logic to transfer IDs. You can calculate the proper material ID values yourself based on the polygon indices. Indices start at zero and continue consecutively. The first object to be merged was the main floor. This means that the polygon indices in the main floor template match exactly with the corresponding indices of the building. They both start at zero. So if the polygon index is less than the number of polygons in the main floor, you can get the material ID directly from the template. Start by getting the polygon index and compare it to the number of polygons in the main floor. If it's less, then you want to set the material ID. In order to look up the proper material ID using the index, you need to put the material IDs of the main floor into an array. You can then select the material ID from the array using the polygon index. Now the building has a bit of color. Transferring the material IDs from the middle floor is going to be a bit more complicated. This is because the main floor was merged first, so the polygon indices of the building do not match the corresponding indices of the middle floor template. In addition, there are multiple copies of the middle floor to deal with. So how can you tell whether a polygon came from the middle floor template? Its index cannot be less than the number of polygons in the main floor, but it must be less than the number of polygons in the main floor and all the copies of the middle floor combined. Calculate the number of polygons in all the middle floors by multiplying the number of polygons in each floor by the number of floors. Add the number of polygons in the main floor and compare the result with the polygon index. Once the condition is in place, you need to calculate the material ID to set. Begin by putting the material IDs of the middle floor into an array. Do this by making a compound and reusing it. You can't use the polygon index to look up values in this array directly. This is because the indices of the building do not match the ones of the middle floor template. First, you need to subtract the number of polygons in the main floor because it was merged first. Now you need to find which polygon on the original middle floor it corresponds to. The first copy of the middle floor is easy because it starts at zero now that you've subtracted the indices of the main floor. But what about the other copies? You need to divide the result by the number of polygons in the middle floor and take the remainder. The modulo node gives you the remainder. Use the remainder to look up the material ID from the array and set it on the building. Now that you've got material IDs on the middle floors, it's time to do the roof. Start by putting the roof's material IDs into an array as before. You know that a polygon belongs to the roof if it doesn't come from the main floor or the middle floor. So you don't need to set up a new condition. You just need to calculate the correct material ID. There's only one copy of the roof, so for a given index, all you need to do is subtract the number of polygons that were added before the roof. You've already calculated the number of polygons in the main floor and all the middle floors combined, so you just need to hook it all up. Now adjust the integer slider again and see how the building updates automatically. Save your results and you're done. You've taken an in-depth look at copying and merging topologies in ICE. You've also seen how to transform topologies and transfer attributes using index offsets and remainders.